After three quarters, you can feel the momentum change to the Minnesota Vikings. They were down at one point 13-0. They now lead 21-20. And momentum, Ed, is one thing you can't measure in statistics or anything else. It just exists.
It never seems to stay with the same team the entire game. And, you sort of feel it that the Vikings were going to, something was going to happen. Yeah. And that score at the end of the first half, that was exactly what they needed.
Wade Wilson is exactly what they needed. He turned them all around.
But he's playing it. A great ball game.
Watch this catch here from Hassan Jones.
This ball is zipped right in there. Boom. That's great concentration.
Duerson hit him just as the ball got there, but he held on. In the third quarter, it was all Vikings, 199 yards in total offense. And Wilson has completed 8 out of 9 for 166 yards and 3 touchdowns and had 1 drop.
And the quarterback controversy is now officially on again.
You're going to have a hard time convincing Wade Wilson if he doesn't deserve to start.
Nelson. Got about 4 yards out of this one. It's a tough little guy, Steve McMichael, on the stop. Nelson came into the game leading the NFC in yards per carry average, almost 6 yards every time he touched the ball. Of course, Bo Jackson has an 8.1 yard average going into today's game.
He doesn't count.
Apparently not. I think he's in another universe. Second and 6 Vikings. Nelson again. Boy, Dent got there, Perry got there, McMichael got there.
See, this is going to happen to Darren Nelson. He's not a big back. But that you accept that part about it, but you know any moment he's going to pop one.
Yep.
He's so dangerous.
They can't find him inside because of his size. Like a Joe Morris, that's the trend, you know, the smaller back.
They found him that time.
And the Vikings will use a timeout on a critical third down call here at the 10-yard line. 13:53 to go in this ball game. Wade Wilson will talk it over on the sideline with Jerry Burns. Back in a minute.
Was presented to the Vincent team.
Palpatine, aggressor tank spotted.
No. In a battle drill, you need horsepower, firepower, people power. That's teamwork.
Moving tank, track front, 2,000.
This team uses a computer, thermal sight, laser rangefinder.
Ah!
The whole tank wins. The whole team wins. Not just one person.
Find your future in the Army.
Konica Tough. Konica's Royal Copiers are tough. Reliability and dependability have earned them a tough reputation. Konica's Royal Copiers, the right choice for tough jobs.
Today you need an insurance company that looks out for you. With experience you can count on. And a firm financial footing. You need the Hartford. When you need us most, we're at our best. That's the Hartford difference.
The S-Class. The engineering flagships of Mercedes-Benz. And something more. Automobiles that evoke memories of a day long past. And a car so exotic that it turned a young boy's head. A heritage of legendary automobiles that have inspired dreams. The Mercedes-Benz S-Class. Nothing less than the best of every big Mercedes there ever was.
ESPN's presentation of the National Football League is being brought to you by the U.S. Army. Learn how to get an edge on life. Be all you can be. And by Konica's Royal Copiers. Not just tough, tough to beat. And by Mercedes, engineered like no other car in the world. Play of the game so far, 3rd and 5, Vikings at the Bear 10.
I said Nelson right out here. Ooh.
And he couldn't hold it. He saw Mike Singletary coming. Even if he catches the ball, he's not going to get the first down with Singletary in front of him. And now Chuck Nelson will come on to try a field goal he missed earlier and has missed, in fact, 6 of his last 8 field goal attempts. Ed, you think that making the extra points may have helped him?
I think it can give him some confidence.
Well, he needs a big dose of it right now. Not a hard field goal attempt.
Right down the middle. Got to make these.
27 yards.
Ba-boom.
That's it. Right in the heart. And the Vikings go up by 4. 24-20.
Jerry's reaction here. Come on, get in. Yeah, that's it.
He's bursting with emotion right now, I'll tell you.
In the stoic tradition of Bud Grant on the Minnesota sideline. We've got 13:47 left to go. If you joined us late, here's what has happened in the game. The Bears offense has stalled. Only 59 yards in the last 5 drives, while the Vikings offense has taken over behind the exceptional play of Wade Wilson, who came off the bench late in the second quarter to replace Tommy Kramer, who had some kind of a nerve injury in his shoulder and has not returned.
Well, anytime you have a Jim McMahon on your team, you're never out of the ball game.
McMahon has done it so many times, bringing the Bears from behind. Ditka knows it, and he loves to have him in there.
They're not worried.
Plenty of time. Plenty of time. Lead could change hands 3 or 4 times.
The man's got that crazed look in his eyes.
A couple of distinctive personalities over there, huh?
I don't think they like to look at each other. They talk, but they don't look at each other.
McMahon says, I would have loved to have played for Mike Ditka. I don't necessarily... I mean, would have liked to play alongside of Mike Ditka. I don't necessarily like playing, you know, for him. He liked his style as a player.
Gentry and Sanders are deep. Gentry. He can fly. And they brought him down at the 35-yard line. Carl Hilton, the reserve tight end, saved a much bigger return that still went for 32 yards.
Gentry almost breaks this one. And it's almost all himself, too. He goes opposite the wedge. They cut the opposite way. Look at this.
This is no surprise to anybody. He's the number 2 kickoff man in the National Football League, averaging 27 yards a return. They've been trying to kick it away from him all night long. Flags are down. They'll stop the play. Guard.
I wonder what he's going to talk about on his radio show tomorrow.
Right now, the Bears need a play, and there's the Viking, who does not look quite right in the dome. Look, you know, you need that frozen beard, you know?
Look, he's wearing Bermuda shorts.
First and 15. Anderson. And then Minnesota defense really swarming. Doug Martin got a hold of the ankle and wouldn't let go.
Great play by Martin. He just stayed put right there. He took on some people and made the play.
Martin has really come on this year. 4th in the conference in sacks. 61 yards in losses.
Wants to be something more than just George Martin's brother, you know? George Martin, of course, a great player for the Giants for so many years. Shut out, by the way, in the sack department a year ago. He's playing like gangbusters this year.
Second and 13. McKinnon, what a catch. Lee and Gogomos right with him, but he's in Minnesota territory, a 20-yard gain.
Now, this is where it takes real courage. You know, going over the middle, watching the ball all the way inside, taking a hit, leaping. This is a real major league catch.
Right there, he was saying, this could hurt. And right here, he's saying, I was right.
Looked like he even a face guard, too, at the bottom of that play. Big night for him.
Mike liked that catch, too.
Dennis McKinnon never afraid to tell you what he's thinking. Anderson behind Thayer. That may be too Studwell. Put him down with a big shoulder. You got to like Studwell. He's done it for 11 years. He just stands in the middle of that 4-3 and chases the ball.
The all-time leading tackler. Even at an advanced age, still plays very, very well. Big hit there.
It's great to watch their eyes as they follow the play.
Why didn't you play defense?
It's a good question. I'd rather not answer that right now.
Ball's at the 47, second and 8. Martin got a real quick start and now gets the sack. The flag came down, but it came down very, very late.
I know what's going on in that line for the referees. Almost plays real late.
Flag came down 6 or 7 seconds after the play started.
I think he threw the flag so high, it looked like it.
The play was ruled dead. False start. Number 78, offense.
They'll call it on Keith Van Horn, saying that's why Martin came across.
He is having a miserable evening tonight, Van Horn. This is about, I think, his third penalty. Maybe his fourth.
He's playing out there at tackle it with this
ball. False start, number 78, offense. Play was ruled dead. Still second down.
The noise factor has to be considered. I mean, Van Horn is a great tackle. I mean, I know the noise has to be affecting him.
Now the officials are going into a conference. Remember, Mike Ditka told us they practiced a silent count. So once they get set, everybody's got to count in their own heads. 1,001, 1,002.
That's murder.
Let me tell you something. And there is an unsportsmanlike conduct call made against the Bears. That'll cost them 15.
We made light of it at the top about how Mike Ditka hates playing in the domes because he doesn't think it befits football. The real reason he doesn't like playing in the dome is because of the noise. Let's face it. This football team can't get on track. They've had a lot of offsides tonight, a lot of false starts. That's what's killing them.
And we don't know why there was an unsportsmanlike call. Mike Hartenstein is into the ballgame on the Minnesota defensive line. A Bear for 12 years in second and 28. McMahon complete to Morris at the 48-yard line.
Terrific.
19-yard gain.
That was the rolling pocket that time. They used the rollout. McMahon's been taking his lumps. He's hurting again.
That unsportsmanlike call, or unsportsmanlike conduct call, we understand, was on the Bears bench. And there's McMahon limping once more.
Looked like he didn't have anybody rushing him, so he might have pulled up late.
Third and 9. Mike Tomczak, the backup quarterback with the hat on. Blitz. And McMahon will run for it. Diving for the first down stick. Let's see where they mark it. A flag is down.
We're going to have a piling on, perhaps.
I don't know about that one.
I don't know.
8-yard gain for McMahon. You see the official pointing at his head. That's going to be a spearing call.
We got a player down.
Wyman Henderson went in there for McMahon, and boy, this is a tough call to make. McMahon was diving headfirst, so was Henderson, trying to stop him from getting to that sideline.
This is a crucial call. First turning call. Point call.
Number 24, unnecessary roughness, first down.
Well, it was tough to see from our angle. The reverse angle, we ought to be able to see it perfectly. McMahon going for the sticks.
No, I don't agree with that. He's playing football right there. He's trying to stop his forward motion. That's a bad call, I think.
And that was is in slow motion. If you run it back in regular speed, it's bang, bang.
And speaking of
bang, he's not even hitting him with his helmet. That's with the shoulder.
Bang, bang, gentlemen, Mr. McMahon is in serious pain at midfield. He is down.
Now, here's the regular speed. Look how quickly it happens. I don't see how you can call it.
Check out McMahon.
That was a gutsy play by McMahon.
Wasn't it?
He's so tough.
Mike Tomczak, who was ready, will come in. And, of course, they're doing everything they can to protect the quarterback. But once you leave the pocket, you don't get that protection. You're the same as anybody else. And they're telling us that Jim McMahon has a pulled hamstring. That's why he's limping.
He doesn't like it.
But Wyman Henderson got there a split second after Jim McMahon was diving for the sticks.
I was just saying he doesn't like what somebody just said to him, the Minnesota side. He was just pointing at somebody and saying something back.
Boy, so Mike Tomczak, the three-year man out of Ohio State, comes into the ball game. So we have two backup quarterbacks in there now. The numbers on Tomczak. His mechanics so much better than a year ago. First pass, almost intercepted. Isaac Holt cut inside of Willie Gauthen, couldn't hold it. Not an auspicious beginning.
That just, that's devastating. An interception to end a drive right here.
Nice play.
That's a great defensive play. Yeah. That wasn't a real bad throw. I think the receiver has to come back from that ball a little bit.
That was a great play by Isaac Holt, who was penalized earlier in the ballgame on a couple of big ones. And there's McMahon. They're working on that hamstring. Sanders behind Thayer. Oh, what a defensive play by David Howard.
It's hard to look in his eyes.
In the USFL, this guy was known as the poor man's Lawrence Taylor. Has played very well.
Right here.
Look at this.
Blocked and makes the play.
Gorgeous.
So this brings up third and 10 in a four-point ball game. The clock running with 10:22 left to go. They're trying to ice down that hamstring. Chicago 4 out of 9 and third down conversions tonight. They hit Dennis Gentry for 14 yards.
He stayed with this catch all the way. Bobbled it. Great concentration. Didn't lose his poise. On the run.
Nice play by Tomczak here.
Rolling out. Downfield. Watch it. Stays with it. Carries it in.
First and 10. Bears down 24-20. What a ball game this has been.
Yes, indeed.
Peyton and Anderson, the split pass. Incomplete in the end zone, intended for Morris. He wanted a flag, but he won't get it.
Terrific coverage. Double coverage, too, on Morris.
You know, as tough as crowd noise is on the Bears, I think McMahon was able to handle it. So far, Tom's actually doing the same thing, but
watch the coverage here, Ed.
Throws it right in there to a lot of people.
Well, he almost got that thing between Steve Freeman and Carl Lee. Second and 10. 9:18 left in the game. The Bears win. They win the division. The Vikings need 2 wins in their last 4 to make the playoffs. Tomczak incomplete. Too high for Cat Boso, the tight end.
And Boso was open.
He was. Joey Browner, the closest man to him.
And now Browner coming up slowly.
Tomczak gets the word from Mike Ditka.
That ball looked like a hockey puck going off the glass.
Boy, Joey Browner's played hurt tonight.
3 wide receivers in the ball game. Now make it 4. The remaining back is Anderson on 3rd and 10. Tomczak got rid of it to Anderson. And Anderson brought down at the 5, Joey Brown. And I think they will rule Tomczak was in the grasp and control of a defender before he threw the ball. If they do, it goes as a minus 1 yard sack.
That was a great athletic move by Tomczak.
Yeah.
Try to make
Stafford
it work.
Mays was the guy who got it.
This was a draw. This is a quarterback draw.
Look at that.
I think he was just down.
Yeah.
Kevin Butler, who has made 13 in a row, including 2 tonight, will try from 30 yards. 14 straight for Kevin Butler. And the Chicago Bears, with an impressive drive, have cut the lead to 1 with 8:51 to play.
Germany, the country that makes the best beer in the world, now makes the best light beer in the world. New Dry Becks Light from Becks. 96 calories, 100% German.
Q101. For more of today's music, Q101.
Why whip something up in a pinch when you can pick something up in a pinch? Ameritech Pages Plus, published by Donnelly Directory. Shop here and shop good.
You hear the thunder, the call of the road. You feel the power, you gotta go. You feel excitement, ride the Bonneville. Get on your Bonneville and ride, Bonneville ride.
Check out the full-size Bonneville at your Chicagoland Northwestern Indiana Pontiac dealers.
Get on your Bonneville, we build excitement.
I'm on the road at all hours, making a lot of quick runs and some very important stops. So I know the value of good brakes. My livelihood and a lot of lives depend on it. When I'm off duty, our lives depend on good brakes. That's why I depend on Meineke.
At Meineke, we do brakes, and we do them right. We analyze the whole system, pinpoint the problem, and fix it, period.
No matter why you're on the road, you can depend on brakes from Meineke. I do.
These are just two examples of why coaches in the National Football League make such a big deal out of backup quarterbacks. Yep. So many guys go down, and you got a Wade Wilson, who has been brilliant tonight, come in and do what he's done, and the game belongs now to Tomczak for the Bears.
And timing being such an important factor, it's got to affect the rhythm of the game when those guys come in, and yet it hasn't appeared as though it did.
Especially since the starter gets most of the work during the week. But for quarterbacks, maybe it doesn't matter that much. Gugemos got to find a handle on it. He's in trouble now. Uh-oh. If he gets out here, he's got a line.
He turned nothing into something right there.
He ran a long way for 3 yards.
No, actually, that was about a 15-yard gain.
He paid for it, too.
Slow getting up. Holding that right thigh. 8:36 to go in the ball game, and it's a 1-point lead. And now the onus is really back on the Vikings to do something on offense to take something out of this.
Now he has problems holding on to the football. This really could have hurt. Picks the ball up, stays with it, and he rolls this way.
That takes guts.
Oh boy.
Right down by the goal line.
To the 1 yard line, yeah. Ran across field. Man, that was really a great effort.
Gugemos is up, gets a nice hand from the Viking faithful here in the Metrodome. It's a nice start for Jerry Burns and the Vikings. Wade Wilson has been almost perfect throwing the ball, dumps it off to Nelson. A one-man screen out there, and will pick up 4, maybe 5 yards. Had Kirk Loudermilk, the center, out in front of him. Dave Duerson took him out of bounds. Now you said, Ed, they needed to get the ball to Nelson, and they have, and it's worked for him.
If you get Nelson out there on the flanks like that, you know, he's gonna make 5 or 6 yards. He's just so quick.
Gugamos has a cramp. He should return. See, Wilson has really had some success. He's played in relief of the injured Tommy Kramer. Rifled that ball. What a shot.
Almost a great catch.
Well done, Marshall.
Gustafson really got level. I don't know how he got up.
Wilbur's just all over the football field. He's having a great game tonight.
Oh.
That's when you go back to the huddle and you tell the quarterback, don't ever do that again.
Except your speech isn't that clear.
Right. You think you're in Cleveland, too.
3rd and 6. Fake to the late defender. And throw for the first down to the tight end, Steve Jordan. Ron Rivera made the tackle, but a big play for the Vikings. 14 yards, and they keep the drive alive.
Go to the tight end too often in this game. First down.
Wade Wilson in a quarter and a half has thrown for 184 yards on 10 out of 13. And we are told that it is more than likely that Jim McMahon will not be back in the ballgame with that hamstring injury. Nelson. Oh. Perry got there before anybody, almost took his head off and then got help. The guy at 300 and whatever can really explode off the line.
Ooh. Amazing that he stayed on his feet even for a moment.
Didn't knock him down.
Todd Bell was in there. They were bringing everybody on that one. Nelson, 11 carries, 25 yards tonight. Remember, he came in leading the NFC at 5.9 yards a carry. He's averaging 2.3 tonight against his Bear defense. Wilson with a quick toss out to Jordan. Duerson rides him down at the 44. He's going to bring up a 3rd and about 5.
Very key series here in terms of the clock. If they can hold on to the football, move deliberately downfield, take 10, 12, 14 plays downfield, and score, they'll not only get the touchdown, they'll have eaten a large piece of that clock up and could make the difference.
Right now, a field goal is what they need. The Bears will have to score a touchdown.
6.5 minutes left. Vikings 8 out of 15 on 3rd down tonight. This is the biggest one they've had so far.
Nelson, ooh!
And Wilson threw it, that one behind it.
And that one hurt. They hate to give this one up, Mike.
And plenty of time left too, Roy. 6:19 to go in the game. And Wilson knew he had him and missed him.
He would like to have that one back.
And he's looking at Darren Nelson like he might have turned the wrong way on the pattern. Coleman to punt. Bears show a 10-man front. Dennis McKinnon, the 4th best punt returner in the NFL, is standing at his 12. Low line drive by Coleman again gets the big bounce. And McKinnon dropped at the 11-yard line.
Joey Browner.
They told us he's the best punt coverage man in the entire National Football League.
He's not too happy about that. He doesn't like playing on that special team.
Wants to be paid for it, right? Here he is going downfield.
I don't blame him either.
Look at that. From out of bounds. Goes downfield. Makes the play right there. Joey Browning, number 47. We'll come back with more after this.
Gonna dance your whole life away. What about your future? Don't you worry about getting
getting old?
He doesn't have to. He has a MetLife retirement plan. MetLife annuities earn tax-deferred interest and guarantee an income for life. What do you say to that?
Hawaii?
Oh, brother. Get Met. It pays.
Dear Pop, I know how anxious you must be to get this letter, but I think you'll find it was worth the wait. As you can see, he's got your eyes, your smile, even your stubborn chin. So we thought he should also have your name. Say hello to Jonathan Jr. Merry Christmas, Pop. We're coming home.
Christmas and Kodak.
Every day, Jack Taylor and Joe Donovan take the same road home. But today, they went a little out of their way.
Give you a hand.
You make America work.
Here's to you, the clean, crisp taste of Beechwood-aged Budweiser.
This bird's...
For all the guys who go out of their way.
This bird's for you.
The Nabisco Masters. Only the best of the best remain. $100,000 goes to the winner of the championship match. See the battle live Monday night at 8 Eastern on ESPN.
6:10 to go in the ball game. Chicago down by a point. They have the football at their own 11. Mike Tomczak, the Chicago quarterback for the injured Jim McMahon.
Big play.
Finney. And they stopped him inside the 1 yard line.
Chris Dolman. Yeah, you're all pro, buddy.
You got that right.
He is tonight, anyway.
He should be for the season.
Certainly has been since the strike.
Wow. From York, Pennsylvania, told us to say hi to everybody up in York, PA. That's where they make the barbells.
Second and goal. Penny. No signal. Singletary made sure he didn't get in there after Todd Bell hit him. Bill Jarrah also in there.
Bell tried to strip the ball.
Jerry Burns wants to know how far away they are. And in this situation, well, here's the play. Nice job by Singletary. In this situation, you may have noticed before, quarterbacks turn around and lie to their coach. They'll tell them it's a lot shorter than it really is because they want to go for it. Third and half a yard. Quarterback keeper. No, sir. And now it's decision time for Jerry Burns.
No,
5:09 to go in the game. What do you do?
They kicked the field goal right here.
There's no doubt in your mind?
No doubt in my mind.
Most coaches in this situation would go for the touchdown. And Jerry Burns wants some time to think about it. He uses his second timeout. I think this is almost a macho kind of situation. Hey, guys, we got a half a yard. Are we going to tell them we can't make a half a yard on them, or what?
They have a yard to go. They tried three shots.
Right.
They didn't even move the ball.
a field goal, and they have to score a touchdown to win.
I agree with you.
Right. Wade Wilson isn't happy with something. He's talking to a ref, and now he's talking to Gustafson, Jordan. Steve Jordan he was just talking to. Now he's going to talk to Jerry, of course.
That was a pretty weak effort at a quarterback sneak.
Yeah. Look, he left his feet too soon or something.
Yeah.
I've got a chance to see it again here. Here it is. Now watch. Yeah,
I mean, you can't leap over the line.
That offensive line is stuffed at the line.
He is not going to do an imitation of Walter Payton hurdling anybody.
Not from a dead stop.
5:01 left in the game. The Vikings lead the Bears by 1 point. With a win tonight, Minnesota would need only one more win in their three remaining games to assure themselves of going to the playoffs.
Haven't made the playoffs in 5 years.
That's right. You have to be happy for Jerry Burns, who has really done quite a job in the last 2 years. They had the debacle of Les Steckel coming in here as head coach. The team really fell flat at that point.
And then they brought Bud Grant back in for that 1 year to sort of get everybody regrouped. And then they think they did the thing they should have done, brought in Jerry Burns.
Has the respect of the entire team.
Players love him. They love to play for him.
And he gives a lot of credit to his coaching staff. He has some excellent assistants. And as a stand-up kind of guy, he says they're great coaches.
He never liked me much. Well, they're going for it.
Fourth and less than a yard.
We're going to roll left here.
Nelson.
No. Well, second guess time.
Todd Bell came roaring up from the strong safety position and stuffed Nelson for a loss of 4.
Not even any doubt about it, too. Great defensive play by Todd Bell.
That's one of the places they may miss DJ Dozier the most.
It looked like they had a long count there. I don't know what they were trying to do.
Trying to draw the defense offside.
Why?
To get a foot, get it closer in, I guess.
Well, the Bears defense did its job. Now it's up to Tomczak.
Great blocking.
Oh! And what a throw. Somehow he got it in there to Emory Moorhead, the tight end, for 23 yards. I didn't think that was ever going to come down.
He had the rolling pocket moving again. They don't throw to the tight end too much. Very poised here. Tomczak out of his own end zone. Good blocking. Look at that. Van Horn, all those guys up front. Down at the other end, Emory Moorhead. Big catch here. Getting him out of trouble.
That's a pretty gutsy throw, too.
Yes, it was.
He wasn't able to zip that ball.
A lot of touch to drop it over the linebackers. There's the clock in the lower right-hand portion of your screen. The Bears have all three timeouts left. And he held on at the 40. That should be another first down. Henderson on the stop. Fine catch by Willie Gault.
That was one of the criticisms of Gault. Can he get the middle, make the catch, not be so timid? He wasn't there, took a big hit. Jerry Burns second guessing himself, I think. You still feel they should have gone for the field goal. Now it looks good.
But I'm not a coach.
Kevin Butler becomes a factor. He's the hottest kicker in the National Football League. Tomczak to Anderson. Great job by Tomczak. Kept his cool in the pocket. Got it off. Studwell made the tackle. A lot of pressure on this play.
Watch the effort here from Chris Dolman. Almost getting inside. Working on Paul Blair, then cutting back inside. Beating number 63, Hilgenberg. And dealing with Walter's block. Almost getting in.
You know what a big play was with Nelson losing 4 yards on that goal line play? Because then you have to line up on your own 1 yard line.
Makes a difference.
Makes a difference.
Jim McMahon all taped and iced up on the sideline. Anderson
The Vikings were all over him in the backfield. Flag goes down. The first guy there was Henry Thomas and got him up around the helmet. Could be a face mask. No, it's holding against the Bears.
That's a big one. That hurts.
Well, if you're losing 4 yards, you shouldn't hold, right? Tom's act to talk to Ditka. We're down to 2:36 to go in the game.
Offense, 10 yards, Tom Eichel,
the right guard, strongest man on the football team.
No, that's a run.
Face mask play there?
No, he had him around the neck. That's legal, grabbing around his neck.
Second and 14, Chicago.
They'll try to get some of it back right now.
Tom Zeck throws that one away.
Nice catch by Butler.
Now this is the play of the game right here. Coming up. And 14. What do you call here, Eddie?
Well, what I would try to do is get the ball underneath to somebody like Walter Payton and let him get the first down. You got to throw underneath because
short stuff, high
short
percentage
stuff, and but let the running back
do the job.
Do the job, right?
Be a more comfortable call for Tom Zach, wouldn't it?
Yeah, and for Ditka also.
Third and 14. 2:10 left. Bears down by one. Pressure and a floater. Gentry couldn't hold it.
That's all
and
right.
Neither could John Harris.
That's all right for the Vikings. They'll take it.
Gentry got his hands on it and couldn't hold it.
Sort of laid that one up there a little bit.
Inside, that was Doug Martin at the last minute, making him hurry it just a bit.
Well, on the replay, it didn't look like Gentry had a chance. Ball thrown behind him and high.
A little bit of a floater there.
They will punt on 4th and 14 with 2:04. They'll have 3 timeouts left to stop the clock. Great punt. Carter's driven all the way back to the 5-yard line. Carter past the 25. A big return by Carter, 19 yards after a 54-yard punt. A minute 53 to go.
I'm not panicking yet, but Tim is our major weapon for this meeting, and I don't see him.
I spoke to him last night. He said he'll meet us there.
What, is he taking a different flight?
He's not flying, he's driving.
He is driving the 300 miles.
He just bought a 190 class Mercedes. Says he's never driven anything like it.
That's great, but why would he want to do all that driving when he doesn't have to?
I guess that's the whole point.
Power tool system more professionals use to work around the house or even build one. Makita, it's all the power you need. Shower massage by Teledyne Waterpik.
At the Pro Bowl that you'll see on ESPN, the Travelers Corporation will present the Travelers NFL Man of the Year Award to the player whose on-field performance is complemented by his community involvement. This year's nominees from the Minnesota Vikings, Darren Nelson, and from the Chicago Bears, Dave Duerson. tuned for SportsCenter immediately following our telecast here from the Metrodome, renamed the Roller Dome.
It's rolling tonight, rocking and rolling.
There you see Chicago with all three timeouts. They'll use them presumably to stop the clock after Minnesota running plays. The Vikings would love to get one first down and wrap it up. Nelson and Anderson, the running backs in the eye. Nelson. Now, Rivera in on the stop. We've got a couple, and they'll use a timeout. And this is why this game is so big. As you take a look at the standings, Chicago on top with a two-game lead. Minnesota could cut that margin to one. It is a two-way race. Chicago, of course, with a win, would wrap up the Central Division for the fourth time in the 80s. No other team has won its division four times in this decade.
The other part of that equation is the rest of the schedule for the Bears. Mm-hmm. They still have to play the 49ers, the Seahawks, and the Raiders. Conversely, the Vikings, while no game is a sure thing, have the lighter schedule.
I don't know. The Packers look pretty tough today.
Didn't they?
But look at it. Green Bay, Detroit, Washington at home. It's a lot easier than what they're having to do, the Bears.
That's kind of scary, though, when you're playing teams that have really nothing to lose.
Right.
You saw that in Seattle when they played the Raiders.
Yep. Hey, what'd you think of Bo Jackson's performance on that Monday night game? Is that unbelievable?
I found it somewhat depressing.
Why?
Because I always used to dream about being in the clear, seeing no one in front of me, and knowing that I was going to score. And that's exactly how he feels.
He's awesome.
Second and seven, Minnesota.
But
the Bears can stop the clock two more times. Anderson on the delay. Gets a couple out to the 33-yard line. And Wilbur Marshall, one of the first
to get
on the tackle.
William Perry stepping on his hand.
Wow. This euphoria, we might mention this. The Vikings lead the league in a very embarrassing category. Most players charged with driving while intoxicated. In the last 15 months, seven Viking players have been involved in an alcohol abuse charge. And only one, Isaac Holt, was jailed and fined. In my opinion here, the league punishes drug abusers, yet it seems to operate on a double standard regarding alcohol abuse. To me, this isn't only hypocritical, it's unconscionable. Drunk drivers pose a greater threat to society than drug abusers. Certainly drug abuse in any form is despicable, but there is that double standard that's operated by the NFL and all of sports. I think they have to address the whole of the drug problem. That's alcohol and illegal drug abuse.
Of course, it all boils down to individuals and how they choose to live their lives.
Unfortunately, football players or any athletes are always under a magnifying glass, and you hear about them in defense of these people.
There's no defending it.
Third and four. Bears have to stop them. And maybe didn't. It all depends on the Marcus Anderson. Hurled his body forward to the 39. He needed to go just past the yard stripe to get the first down. And the officials will stop the clock to measure this one.
I don't think they got it.
I think they're about 2 or 3 inches short. The stick is marked just past the yard mark. The Bears would have one timeout left. They could use it right after the measurement or hold it. And it is short, less than the length of a football.
Now this is an extremely crucial play. Possession play, the key play of this football game.
And the pressure is on Greg Coleman, whose last three or four have been low-line drives that only went about 25 yards in the air.
You send the team in there to block this now? Or do you run the risk of a penalty here? Blocking?
I think that there's plenty of time left for the Bears. Again, they only need a field goal here.
I send them all. I think it's that crucial right now.
McKinnon, remember, has two punt returns for touchdowns this year, 94 and 65.
Here they come.
Another low line drive kick taken by one of the upmen at the 30. They'll get it back to the 38-yard line. And that's Dewerson. And the crowd does not like the performance of the Minnesota kicking game.
Neither does Mr. Coleman.
No, Greg's not happy about it at all. He's a much better kicker than that. And the Vikings didn't take any time off that clock. Mm. They kicked it with 27 seconds left on the 30-second clock.
Bears have one timeout. It's a big one.
Last chance for Tomczak. Anderson, big hole. Look out. Jesse Solomon ran him out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
And it took only 9 seconds off the clock.
And he stopped the clock.
20-yard gain for the second-year man out of the University of Florida.
Great bounce. Oh.
That's a big play right there.
Eluding Joey Browner. Great, great effort.
Kevin Butler waits on the sideline. He beat the Packers earlier this year with no time on the clock. Tomczak incomplete for McKinnon, Wyman, Henderson on the coverage.
And McKinnon was open.
And Ditka really upset at his quarterback.
He knows it. Oh, they've got to get about 10, 15 yards upfield. Here's Ditka's react. Come on, Mike, let's go.
Second and 10. From the Viking 41. Four wide receivers. Anderson, the lone back. Gentry gets it down to the 38-yard line.
You see, I think that's a mistake to do that to Tomczak in this situation.
Why?
Because, I mean, the guy, the last thing he needs is to see his coach screaming at him because he might have thrown the ball in the wrong place.
Gentry, first down, look out!
There it is!
Touchdown, Bears! Do you believe that? Gentry broke a tackle, set sail, and nobody could knock him down. Gentry came into this game with 5 catches and no touchdowns all year. His biggest play of the season. And Tim McMahon, with ice on his arm and his leg, is now the head cheerleader for Chicago.
Wow. What an effort.
Tomczak's stock sure went up. That was just a great play.
Butler for the point after to make it a 6-point game.
A great game, too.
And it is. Watch Gentry. He gets the credit on this one. A great individual effort.
He's a converted running back. And he does a lot of this running on his own here, just eluding one defender there. Great piece of running here. Breaking another tackle there, going on in. Beautiful.
Be a real test for the Minnesota Vikings. This telecast presented by authority of the National Football League, intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of the telecast without the express written consent of the National Football League is prohibited. So now Wade Wilson will have to perform another miracle.
With one timeout, they got to get 6 points in 40 seconds.
For course, you'd have to think, the way Wilson has played so far tonight, if anybody's going to do it, he could.
Well, they need a good return right here.
They won't get an opportunity, I don't think, to get a ball where they can set up. This will have to be a broken kind of play, the ball bounding around.
Well, they're putting Darren Nelson deep.
SportsCenter follows this telecast. Nelson, who averages 22.7 on kickoff returns, will have a shot at this one if the Bears kick it deep to him.
This reminds me of the scenario a few years back when Ahmad Rashad came up on that last play of the game, scored that touchdown on the bomb from, I think it was Tartan. It may have been Tommy Kramer.
I think it was Kramer.
It was Kramer. It reminds me of the same scenario.
Nelson.
Fabulous. And if Butler doesn't make this play, folks, we're tied. Because he would have cut outside.
Great field position, though, with 33 seconds left. A field goal does them no good.
Oh, what a game.
Three wide receivers and the shotgun. Dent with the pressure, and they got there. Dent paused it, and Al Harris got the sack along with Vic Michael. That will temporarily stop the clock.
And Al Harris might get another $100 from McKinnon.
Fifth sack of the game. And
this
Minnesota used as its last timeout.
That's Dent really forcing the play, and Harris cleaning up.
Well, the Vikings are in a tough position now with 28 seconds left, no timeouts.
Seems stranger things happen.
The clock will stop on first downs to move the chains, but that's all.
What about trickery stuff? Hook and ladder plays, you know?
Nah. Of course, it might be as good as anything at this point.
I think they're just going to have to use the sidelines here. Get as much as they can.
Got 62 yards to go in 28 seconds. Wilson has performed brilliantly coming in after Kramer was injured. Bears have broken a lot of hearts in the fourth quarter over the years, especially with McMahon in there. This time it was Tomczak.
Viking secondary. That's Joey Browner, of course, representing the whole of the Felix.
Bears continue to come with a four-man rush. That's how they got to them last time. Wilson bombs away, throwing for Hassan Jones, who almost made the catch over Jackson's shoulder. Oh, that was so close.
Now you got third and 16. You still have to get a first down here, too, fellas. Here's the coverage. That's Vesty Jackson on the play. No, actually, Jackson
right through his hands.
Jackson should have had it, perhaps. Although he was
Hassan
obstructed.
Jones timed it beautifully and looked like he could have made the catch. 22 seconds to go. Well, they need the bomb. A little dump-off pass, unless they can run it in, will eat up most of the clock. Three-man rush this time. Wilson throws sideline. Gustafson. First down and out of bounds.
Very nice.
16 seconds left.
Very nice.
18-yard grab for Gustafson, who came into the game with no catches, has three tonight.
Got time for maybe three plays without the timeout. He can work it properly.
Got to work the sidelines here. If you can get inside, get around the 20-yard line, then you can throw for the end zone.
Wade Wilson, in a half of football, has thrown for 211 yards and three touchdowns. But it won't matter unless he can get this one. Hail Mary. And incomplete. And eight guys around the ball, including Anthony Carter and Leo Lewis.
I thought I saw Ahmad Rashad in there somewhere. Here it is. He's just hoping for a break, you know, ball bouncing off somebody else. You know, you see the way they shield it, though? They really keep their eye on where they are on the field.
Jazon Jones, 84, and Duerson playing center field. That took 8 seconds off the clock, and there are 8 seconds left.
That's not a very happy camper right there.
No. Another Hail Mary. This was the ball game. And batted away incomplete. That's it. The Chicago Bears, after blowing a 13-point lead, come back in the fourth quarter behind substitute quarterback Mike Tomczak and get a 35-yard touchdown pass to Dennis Gentry, and the Bears, for the fourth time in the decade of the 80s, have won the NFC Central. And now the Vikings still need two wins in their last three games to make the playoffs in 1987.
Here it is, the last play of the game. Never any question.
Our thanks to Ed Marinaro, our guest analyst tonight out of Cornell and the Minnesota Vikings. Ed, it was a pleasure to have you with us. Hope we'll get you back sometime.
I hope so. I had a great time, guys.
Thanks, Eddie.
Our final score here at the Metrodome, the Chicago Bears 30, the Minnesota Vikings 24. On behalf of all of our ESPN crew, Ed Marinaro and Roy Firestone, this is Mike Patrick saying so long from Minnesota. Let's go to SportsCenter.
Good evening. Eyewitness News is coming up next, and for a few minutes, it looked as though the Bears had lost the Central Division title. But no. When the dust settled after another heart-stopping finish, it was clear we don't have to wait another week. We'll go live to Minnesota for...